I was 15 years old when I had to undergo an open heart surgery. I was hospitalized for 1 year. It was like a near-death experience, and when it was successful, I said to God, "You have given me new life. I will spend this life thanking you." That the purpose of life is to sustain ourselves, our family, and contribute to society. I was always doing some kind of free service, but I was never happy. I was invited to Rio de Janeiro for the first Earth Summit in 1992. That's where I learned about environmental problems all over the world. I came with understanding and with the commitment that never in my life I'm going to do anything which will harm environment. Jimmy McGilligan Center is just all my work dedicated to my beloved husband who has passed away. Both of us decided that we will first make this campus 100% sustainable. So we made 6 acres of land, all organic, and he made first solar kitchen. Seeing that, the girls said, "We want to have solar cookers in our villages." Solar cookers have saved their dignity because they get a lot of sexual harassment and rapes because they have to walk miles, 20 miles, 30 miles to get the wood. Then some woman told us that they used to get miscarriage in pregnancy when they had to walk with heavy load of wood. Slowly we kept on learning and we kept on finding solutions. So it was more than trees. It was just saving not trees, but the dignity of women, life of women. And my husband and me used to say, cooking in smoky kitchens is violence against women. But we were thinking only of smoke. We never knew about that part. In 2007, I also got 4 surgeries of cancer. I decided that I must leave my institute in good hands. So we decided to choose a small hilltop which was abandoned and was a rock. Not even there were bushes. It was nothing, barren small hilltop. We designed a house with no use of electricity. And then we started doing trees and plants, and in half an acre, while we were building the house, we were about to come, we both met with an accident, my husband and me, and I lost him. But he had built a solar and wind power station to give free power to 50 tribal families of untouchables. People who were dumped out of the village, they were my neighbors. And in this half an acre of land, we started growing our food, everything. And I only buy salt, sugar, tea leaves, and cooking oil. We also set up a solar kitchen and we make our own fuel. It's almost smoke-free briquettes. I also open my house to people to come and learn. As Mahatma Gandhi also says, not to live with greed. We should have to our need and also think about others.